Hello, this is the lecture number 7 and we are of the chapter sets of class 11th and we are starting with the miscellaneous exercise. First of all, we'll do the question number, last four question of this exercise. Then we'll start with the question number 1 because these questions based on, as we have done in the last lecture, that is the word problem based on the Venn diagram. So in question number 16, I'm taking, it is given that in a survey that it is found that 21 people like product A, 26 like product B, and 29 like product C. So there are three sets, set A, set B, and set C. You know how to draw the three sets in a Venn diagram. And how many parts we have? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, like this you mark it here. And this set, circle A, denotes the number of person who like the product A, that is A plus B plus C plus E is given. That is 28. The number of person who like product B is given as 26. The number of person who like product B is A plus B plus D plus F. It is 26. The number of person who like product C is given as 29. So it is A plus C plus D plus G, which is given equal to 29. And after that, it is given that the number of person who like the product A and B is given as 14, that is A plus B, it is given as 14. The number of person who like product A and C is given as 12, that is A plus given, it is 12. The number of person who like product A, B and C, it is given as equal to 14. So B plus C is A plus D, it is given as 14. The number of person who like all the three product is 8. It is given that it is equal to 8. So this data is given and you have to find how many person like only product C. That is the number of person who like product C only is G. That is the value of G you have to find. So how many data is given? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now you can find all the values of A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Now if you replace the value of A in this, you'll get the value of D. If you replace the value of A as 8, you'll get the value of C. If you replace the value of A as 8 here, then you'll get the value of B. When you replace the value of A, B, C here, you'll get the value of E. When you replace the value of A, B, D here, you'll get the value of F. If you replace the value of A, C, D, you'll get the value of G here. So you have to obtain all the individual parts, that is A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Now the in this question, you have to find only the value of G. The number of person who like only product C is G. So the answer is here 11, but I adding one or two parts in this also. How many like exactly two product? So how many like exactly two product is B plus C plus D. How many like exactly A and B? It is B. How many like exactly A and C? It is C. How many like exactly B and C? It is D. So B plus C plus D you have to find. Now how many like exactly one product? So exactly one product is E. The person of number person who like exactly product A is E. Exactly B likes F and exactly C likes G. So E plus F plus G is the number of persons who like exactly one product. So I've added these two part in question number 16. In question number 15, just same as question number 16, it is given that in a survey of 60 people, it was found that 25 people like read newspaper H and 26 read newspaper T and 26 read newspaper I. So I represented these H by circle H, denoting the number of person reading newspaper H. By T, I have denoted that number of person reading the newspaper T, and this I, the number of person reading newspaper I. So it is given that the number of person who is reading newspaper H is A plus B plus C plus E. It is given as equal to 25. The number of person who reading newspaper T is B plus A plus D plus F is equal to 26. The number of person who's reading newspaper I is A plus C plus D plus G is equal to 26. It is also given that the number of person who is reading newspaper H and I, that is H and I, A plus C is given as 9. The number of person who is reading newspaper both H and T, that is A plus B, is given as 11. The number of person who is reading both the newspaper टी एंड आई दैट इज ए प्लस डी इज गिवन एज 8 एंड द नंबर ऑफ पर्सन हु इज रीडिंग ऑल द 3 न्यूज़पेपर इज गिवन एज इक्वल टू 3 दैट इज ए इज गिवन 3. नाउ एज वी हैव डन इन द क्वेश्चन नंबर 16 पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए हेयर यू विल गेट डी पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए हेयर यू विल गेट बी पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए हेयर यू विल गेट सी व्हेन यू पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए बी सी हेयर यू विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ ई व्हेन यू रिप्लेस ए बी डी हेयर यू विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ व्हेन यू रिप्लेस ए डी सी हेयर यू विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ जी. Now it being asked that how many person like at least one of the newspaper. So at least one means either they are reading only one newspaper or two newspaper or all the three newspaper. It means you have to find A plus B plus C plus D plus F plus G plus. You have to find this. Now, how many like exactly one newspaper as we have done in the question number 16, exactly one newspaper, exactly one is E plus F plus G, that is E plus F plus G, and how many like none of the newspaper, so how can we do it? The total 60% survey was done and 52% read at least one of the newspaper, so it means you have to subtract 52 from 60, you'll get 8, the number of person who reads none of the newspaper. So this is both are very important question and they are very good questions also based on the Venn diagram. In question number 14, based on the two sets only, in question number 14, it is given that in a group of 100 students, 100 student know Hindi and 50 know English. So you have to draw the two circles only. So AH and E, H and E, Hindi and English. 100 student know Hindi. So A plus B given as 100, 50 know English, that is A plus C given as 50, and 25 know both, that is the value of A is given. So you replace the value of A here, you'll get B. Replace the value of A here, you'll get C. So B you know, C you know, and A you know, it being said, the total, how many students are there in the group, that it means you have to find A plus B plus C. Now in question number 13, in a survey of 600 people in a school, 150 students found to be taking tea. So taking tea and taking coffee, so the number of person taking tea is A plus B, it is given as 150. The number of person taking coffee, which is 225, it is given as A plus C. And the 100 person taking both the drinks, that is A, is given as 100. And the total survey is given as to be taken from 600, so it means universal set is given as 600. You have to find how many like and neither taking neither tea nor coffee. So what you have to do, you have to find the shaded portion in this, that is A plus B. Put the value of A here, you'll get B. Put the value of A here, you'll get C. So A plus B plus C is 100 plus 50 plus 125. It is subtract from 600, that is from the number of person from whom the survey is taken, you'll get the number of person, which is 325, taking neither tea nor coffee. So these are the questions based on the Venn diagram, and these are very important questions. Now in question number 12, it is given that you have to find two sets such that A intersection B, B intersection C, and A intersection C are non-empty, means there should be some element common in A and B, B and C, and A and C, and you have to take those three sets such that their intersection A intersection B intersection C should be empty. So I have taken an example which is a set containing element 1, 2, 3, B containing 3, 4, 5, C containing 5, 6 and 1, then 5, 6 and 1. Now A intersection B, which is 3, which is not empty, you have to take that example that A intersection B should not be empty. B intersection C coming out to be 5, which is not empty, and A intersection C is coming out to be 1, which is not empty, but in A, B and C none of the element is common, so it means A intersection B intersection C is empty. Now you can take any other example satisfying this condition, there can be infinite number of answers. In question number 11, it is a theoretical question. It is given that if A intersection X is equal to B intersection X is equal to empty, then A union X is equal to B union X, then you have to show that A is equal to B. So you have to show that A is equal to B. So I'm starting with A. So for A, you can write A union empty. So because A union empty, is equal to A. The value of MT is given as B intersection X. It is given that B intersection X is equal to MT. So I replace MT with B intersection X. Now using the distributive law, A union B, A union X, and intersection sign between them. Now A union B is given as equal to B union A, and A union X is given as equal to B union X. It is given in the question. Now we have opened this distributive law. Now combine this distributive law, because B union A intersection X will be equal to B union A and B union X intersection between them. So I have combined this distributive law like this. So B union A intersection X is given equal to MT, and B union MT will be equal to B. So A is equal to B. So in place of MT, we have written B intersection X. In B intersection X, it is given equal to A union X, and using the distributive law, A union B, A union X, intersection between them, A union X is given equal to B union X, and combining the distributive law, that is A B union A intersection X, and A intersection X is given as MT. So this is the question number 11. Now in question number 10, you have to show that A intersection B is equal to A intersection C. Then it is not to say that B is equal to C. So I have taken as an example that A intersection B is equal to A intersection C, but A B will not equal to C. So I have taken an example. A is equal to 1, 2, 3, and B is equal to 3, 4, 5, and C is equal to 3, 5, 6. Here A intersection B is equal to A intersection C, which is coming out to be 3. A intersection B and A intersection C is coming out to be 3, but B and C are not equal. You can take any other example, the answer can vary. Now when you have to prove something false, you can prove it by taking the example, but whenever you have to prove something true, then you have to prove it theoretically. So be very careful. In question number 9, you have to, using the property of the sets, you have to prove that A union A intersection B is equal to A. So I'm starting with the left hand side, A union A intersection B. So A union A, A union B, using the distributive law, A union A is equal to A, and A union B, it is given, so A intersection A union B will be equal to A, because A is a subset of A union B. That is why it is equal to A. Similarly, in the second part, A intersection A union B, using the distributive law, A intersection B, in between we have union sign. A intersection A is A, because common in A and A will be A, and the union of A union A intersection B will be equal to A, because A intersection B is a subset of A, and A is a subset of A union B. In question number 8, you have to prove that, see, read it very carefully, that A is equal to A intersection B union A minus B, and in the second part you have to prove that A union B minus A is equal to A union B. Now we are starting with A. For A, you can write A intersection, they are universal, and universal you can write B union B complement, and using the distributive law, A intersection B complement. For A intersection B complement, you can write A minus B, because A intersection B is equal to A minus B. So A intersection B is equal to A minus B. This we have proved. Similarly, in the second part, A union B minus A, in the left hand side, in the second part of this question. So for B minus A, you can write B intersection A complement like this. And using the distributive law, A union B, A union A complement, an intersection sign between them, A union B and A union A complement is equal to universal set, and the intersection of universal with A union B will be equal to A union B. So therefore, A union B minus A is equal to A union B. Now in question number 7, you have to tell whether power set of A union power set of B, then it is true to say that power set of A into power set of B. No, it is not true. We can prove it, because power set of A union power set of B is equal to power set of A union B. Let the set A, because we have proved that it is false, so we can prove it by taking the example. So let set A is containing the element 1, set B containing the element 2, and A union B will equal to 1 and 2. Now the power set of A is a set of all subset of A, which is MT and 1. So this is a power set of A. Power set of B is a set of all subset of B, which is 5 and 2 with curly bracket. Now power set of A union power set of B will be MT, 1 and 2. And power set of A union B, which is 1, 2, it will have 4 subsets, that is MT, 1, 2 and 1, 2, they are not equal to each other. So power set of A union B is not equal to power set A into power set of B. In question number 6, it is given that power set of A is equal to power set of B, then you have to show that A is equal to B. So be very careful, I am taking the element X in set A. Then if the element belong to a set A, then the set X will be the subset of A. Now it implies that when curly bracket X is a subset of A, then curly bracket X will be belongs to power set of A. Now if this is a subset of this, then curly bracket A1 belongs to the power set of A. So now if it is given that power set of A is equal to power set of B, so it means curly bracket X belongs to power set of B. Now if you remove this power set, then this will become the subset of B. Now because, and if curly bracket is a subset of B, then X will belongs to B. Now if we remove the curly bracket, then the element will belong to the set. So where X belongs to A and X belongs to B, it means that A is a subset of B. Similarly, we can say that B is a subset of A. So therefore, A is equal to B. So this is the completion of your chapter sets. Be very careful with this theoretical part in the miscellaneous exercise, and the word problem based on the Venn diagram is important. Okay, thank you.